Hello, brothers and sisters. This is a continuation of HTML forms. In the previous tutorial, you learned your first HTML form input. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to label your input. So let's get started. Okay, guys, now I will duplicate this one here. All right, this one, I will say the type will be password, all right? This one will be password here, okay? This one is password. Let me change the ID name to password too. Password, let me save it. The only difference between these two text fields is like this one here, when I type something, it shows the characters, all right? But here, the characters are masked. You can see now, they are just bullets. You cannot see them. And that is because the type is password. Okay? All right. Now, what if we want to label our input? Because now the user will not differentiate between the two. They will not know which one is for password and which one is for username. Okay? So, to do that, we will use the label tag. And then we write this attribute for. And then we write the name of our ID here. All right? Now, the name is username. So we will put this username here. Username, right? This one, we are letting it know that this label is for username. So here, I will write the text that will be displayed. Username, right? Okay, let me save it. You will see. Yeah, you can see now our label has been shown here, username. Okay, let me copy this one and paste it here. All right, now I will do the same. I will change the for value to password. Save it, refresh. You can see username. Oh, this one, it's because I have not changed the text that is being displayed there. So I will say password too. This one doesn't matter. Okay. Let me save it. Now, it is kind of messed up. Let me put some breaks here. I will say BR. Yeah, you can see. Let me put another BR so that there's more space. All right. Okay. You can see now we have our label side by side with our input. Now, this ID here and for, the reason why they have to match is because when I click here, right? When I click here instead of here, it will know that I want to write something here. Let me do that. You see? Now it knows, once I click here, it knows I want to write something here. Let me show you when they are not matching, right? So this one is username and this one is username. Let me remove one character here, save it, reframe my page. You see, I'm clicking here and nothing happens, right? So let me return the character I deleted. Refresh, you can see, same to this, right? Okay, now you know how to label your input. Right, that's all for this tutorial. In the next tutorial, you will learn how to add a button so that when you fill out the information needed here, right, you'll be able to submit it. But now we are not going to submit them anywhere because that one requires server-side language, which you will learn